Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the collector feedback biasing configuration of the BJT. Now in the earlier videos, we had seen the different biasing configuration of the BJT. And we had seen that for the BJT, the design biasing circuit should be such that even if there is a change in the external parameters like a temperature, then there should be a minimum change in the operating point. So in this collector feedback biasing configuration, the circuit tries to stabilize the operating point through the negative feedback. And as its name suggests, here the feedback is provided from the collector to base terminal via this resistor RB. Now here, as we are interested in the DC analysis, so for the DC voltages, these capacitors will act as an open circuit. And before we jump into the DC analysis, let us intuitively understand how the circuit tries to stabilize the operating point. So let's say, due to the temperature, if the collector current IC increases, then the voltage drop across this resistor RC will also increase. And due to that, the collector voltage or the voltage at this node will reduce. Now if we assume this base emitter junction is forward biased, then the voltage at this node is equal to VBE, or that is equal to roughly 0.7 volt. So as the voltage VC reduces, then the base current IB will also reduce. And due to that, the collector current IC will also reduce, because this collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. So in this way, this circuit tries to stabilize the any change in the collector current. But let us do the DC analysis and let us understand how well the circuit is able to stabilize the operating point. And first of all, let us mark all the currents in the circuit. Now the first thing, if you notice over here, the current through this resistor RC is equal to IC dash, and that is the summation of the base current and the collector current. And here this collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. So if the value of beta is very high, in that case this collector current is much larger than the base current. And due to that, in this expression, we can neglect the base current. Or approximately, we can say that this current IC dash is equal to IC. So now, we can say that the current through this resistor RC is equal to IC, while the current through this resistor RB is equal to IB. And the voltage between this base and the emitter terminal is equal to VBE. So now, to find the base current, let us apply the KVL on the input side. So applying the KVL, we can write voltage VCC minus IC times RC, that is the voltage drop across this resistor RC, minus IB times RB, minus VBE, that is the voltage drop between this base and the emitter terminal, that is equal to 0. That means voltage VCC minus VBE is equal to IB times RB plus IC times RC. Now we know that the collector current IC is equal to beta times base current. So we can write this expression as voltage VCC minus VBE is equal to IB times RB plus beta times IB times RC. Or we can say that the base current IB is equal to voltage VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus beta times RC. So this will be the expression of the base current. And we know that the collector current IC can be given as beta times IB. So once we know the value of this collector current, then by applying the KVL on this output side, we can find the value of the voltage VCE. So applying the KVL, we can write voltage VCC minus IC times RC, that is the drop across this resistor RC, minus voltage VCE, that is equal to 0. Or we can say that this voltage VCE is equal to VCC minus IC times RC. And in this way, we got the expressions for the base current, the collector current and the voltage VC for this given configuration. Now, although through the negative feedback, this circuit tries to stabilize the operating point, but here there isn't enough negative feedback. So to improve the stability, the additional feedback can be applied through the emitter resistor. So this circuit is the collector feedback bias with the emitter resistor. And this circuit is also known as the collector and the emitter feedback bias. So now, let us find the expressions for the collector current and the voltage VC. And for that, first of all, let us mark the currents in the given circuit. Now, once again, here the current through the resistor RC is equal to IC dash. And this current IC dash is equal to IC plus IB. But as I said earlier, we can approximately say that this current IC dash is equal to IC. Similarly, here we are assuming that this collector current is approximately equal to emitter current. So considering that, now let us find the expression of the base current. And for that, now let us apply the KVL on this input side. So applying the KVL, we can write voltage VCC minus IC times RC, that is the drop across this resistor RC, minus IB times RB, minus voltage VB, minus IE times RE, that is the drop across this resistor RE, that is equal to 0. Now here, we are assuming that this emitter current and the collector current are almost same. So we can replace this emitter current with the collector current. And we can write this expression as voltage VCC minus VB, that is equal to IB times RB plus IC times RC plus RE. And here, this collector current IC can be given as beta times IB. So from this, we can say that voltage VCC minus VB is equal to IB times RB plus beta times IB times RC plus RE. Or we can say that the base current IB is equal to voltage VCC minus VB divided by RB plus beta times RC plus RE. So this will be the expression of the base current. And we know that this collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. So in this way, we can also find the collector current. And once we know the value of this collector current, then we can easily find this voltage VC. And for that, let us apply the KVL on this output side. So applying the KVL, we can write voltage VCC minus IC times RC minus voltage VC, that is the drop between these two terminals, minus IE times RE, that is equal to 0. Or we can say that voltage VC is equal to VCC minus IC times RC plus RE. So this will be the expression of the voltage VC. So in this way, we got the values of the base current, the collector current and the voltage VC. Now here if you observe, if the value of RB is much less than this term, that is the beta times RB plus RE, in that case, this resistor RB can be neglected. And in that case, this base current IB can be given as voltage VCC minus VB divided by beta times RC plus RE. And as the collector current IC is equal to beta times IB, so this beta will get cancelled out. And due to that, this current IC will become independent to the value of beta. That means whenever this condition is satisfied, then this collector current IC will become independent to the variation in the beta. But practically, to operate this BJT in the linear region, it is not possible to make the value of RB very small. and it will get clear to you once we go through the example. And in that example, we will also see how the operating point of the circuit changes if there is a variation in the beta. So let us take one example. So in this example, first of all, let us find the value of the collector current and the voltage Vc. And for that, first of all, let us find the value of the base current using this expression. So we can say that the base current Ib is equal to 12 volt minus 0.7 volt divided by 300 kilo ohm plus 50 times 4.7 plus 1 kilo ohm. And that is equal to 19.6 microampere. So this will be the value of the base current. And the collector current IC can be given as beta times IB. That means this collector current IC is equal to 50 times 19.6 microampere. And that is equal to 0.965 milliampere. And once we get the value of this collector current, then using this expression, we can find the value of the voltage Vc. So this voltage Vc can be given as 12 volt minus 0.965 milliampere times 4.7 kilo ohm plus 1 kilo ohm. And that is equal to 6.5 volt. So in this way, the value of the collector current IC is equal to 0.965 milliampere, while the value of voltage Vc is equal to 6.5 volt. And if you see over here on the load line, the operating point would be somewhere around here, because here the maximum value of the voltage Vc could be equal to 12 volt, while the maximum collector current is equal to 12 volt divided by 5.7 kilo ohm. That is roughly equal to 2.1 milliampere. Now in the same circuit, let's see what happens when the value of the beta increases to 100. So once again, let us find the value of the base current using this expression. That means the base current IB can be given as 12 volt minus 0.7 volt divided by 300 kilo ohm plus 100 times 5.7 kilo ohm. And if we calculate the value, then this base current IB is equal to 12.98 microampere. And the collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. That means this collector current IC is equal to 100 times 12.98 microampere. That is equal to 1.298 milliampere. Or roughly we can say that it is equal to 1.3 milliampere. And once we know the value of this collector current, then using this expression, we can find the value of the voltage Vc. So this voltage Vc is equal to 12 volt minus 1.3 milliampere times 5.7 kilo ohm. That is the summation of this 4.7 and 1 kilo ohm. So if we calculate the value, then this voltage Vc will come out as 4.6 volt. That means now, due to the change in the value of beta, the voltage Vc has become 4.6 volt, while the value of the collector current IC has become 1.3 milliampere. That means with the increase in the value of beta by 100%, this collector current has increased by roughly 30%, while the value of the voltage Vc is roughly reduced by the 34%. That means we can say that although this collector feedback bias provides the improved performance over the fixed bias configuration, but still there is a variation in the operating point. Now if you notice over here, in this example, this condition, that is the RB is much less than beta times RC plus RA, is not satisfied, because over here the value of RB is 300 kilo ohm, while the value of beta times RC plus RE is equal to 570 kilo ohm, considering the value of beta is equal to 100. And if we consider the value of beta as 50, in that case, this term will be equal to 285 kilo ohm. But to satisfy this condition, suppose if we reduce the value of RB by 10 times or increase the value of this RC and RE by 10 times, in that case, the operating point would go near the saturation. and we are no longer able to use this BJT as an amplifier. And even you can try it by yourself. So try to get the operating point whenever the value of RB is equal to 30 kilo ohm. So in conclusion, this configuration provides the slight improvement in the stability, but still there is a variation in the operating point due to the external parameters. And when someone requires a very stable operating point, then one should prefer a voltage divider configuration over the other configurations, because by properly selecting the values, that configuration provides the better stability. And that is why it is the widely used biasing configuration. So in the next couple of videos, we will talk more about the stability. But I hope in this video, you understood the character feedback biasing configuration of the BJT. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.